Live from San Francisco, it's theCUBE. Covering Google Cloud Next 19. Brought to you by Google Cloud and its ecosystem partners.
Welcome back everyone, live here in San Francisco at Moscone. This is theCUBE's live coverage of Google Next 2019, hashtag Google Next 19. I'm John Furrier with Stu Miniman, as well as Dave Vellante, who's been co-hosting. He's out there getting stories and getting all the scoop. We're here with two great guests, CUBE alumni. We're delighted to have Aparna Sinha, Group Product Manager at Google, and Hen Goldberg, Director of Engineering at Google, both the architects of the big wave that we're riding, containers, Kubernetes, and Anthos. Guys, great to see you. Thanks for coming on again.
Thanks for having us. Great to be here.
So you were smirking last night when we saw each other at the press gathering, knowing what was coming. Watched the keynote. I watched the keynote.
Good.
It was awesome. I didn't get a chance to see the spotlight session you guys just had, Anthos, obviously the rebranding and the additional integration points for making things run end to end. This is our dream come true. DevOps, infrastructure as code, is happening. We've been talking about this for a while. You guys are behind it all. Give us the update.
Yeah, so we've been hard at work over the last 8 months since our last Next. Can you believe that it's only been 8 months?
Yes.
And last year we were here announcing GKE on-prem. This year, we've rebranded CSP to Anthos and enlarged it, and we've moved it to GA. So that's the big announcement. In our spotlight, we actually walked through all the pieces and gave three live demos, as well as had two customers on stage. And really the big difference in the 8 months is while we're moving to GA now, we've been working throughout this time with a set of customers. We saw unprecedented demand for what we announced last year, and we've had that privilege of working with customers to build a product, which is what's unique, really.
Yeah.
And so we had two of those folks up on stage talking about the transformation that Anthos is creating in their companies.
Well, I want to get to the customer focus a little bit later, but I want to just get it out on the record while you're here, because there's not a lot of time on stage other than the great demo Jennifer Lin did. What actually is the difference? What's the new things? Because obviously it's a rebrand. Some people might say, oh, they're just rebranding the announcement from last year. What were the new things? What are the new elements of Anthos? Why is it important? What does it mean? What's under the covers? Tell us what's new.
Yes, so first of all, let's talk about what is Anthos, right? So Anthos is a Google opinion managed solution that lets you write once, deploy anywhere. And really the key thing about Anthos is choice. What we've been hearing from our customers, how much they appreciate choice in their journey to the cloud and modernization in general. So the main thing that we've announced is that everything we've announced last year is GA, right? So talking about GKE on-prem and Anthos now, Anthos config management and our marketplace and the control plane for managing multiple clusters, all of that has moved to GA. But when thinking about choice, we've added new capabilities. And one choice that customers are thinking about, do I need to choose a single cloud provider? And now we had a discussion just yesterday with one of the customers, and they said that when they exclude a cloud provider from their strategy, they're actually blocking their own innovation, and that might create even a bigger risk for them. So we know that customers are adopting a multi-cloud strategy. So the big announcement here is that we are moving towards, or maybe we are even leaning more into multi-cloud. We already had other solutions that were talking about it, and definitely with Kubernetes and Istio talking about open APIs, but we are leaning in towards multi-cloud strategy. So that would be one. The second thing that talks about choice is how do we start, okay? And one thing we are hearing from our customers is the importance that they want to innovate with what they have. So Anthos Migrate lets them take their existing applications, package applications that are running today on VMs, and onboard to Anthos automatically and see value. So those are the top two announcements, and I think the third one will be around all the partnerships, which is part of the people we've been working with.
That's
in
awesome.
8 months.
So, I'm sorry, the Migrate piece, is that's not GA yet, is that my understanding?
No, it's okay. Moving to beta.
It's moving to beta this quarter.
So Stu, you and I have been talking about applications, renaissance, multi-cloud, obviously is a reality for enterprises, and now you got the hybrid model. This is kind of in the main themes of what this all means with Anthem. So it's holistically looking at the cloud, as you said, not just Google Cloud.
Right.
This is a key nuance. It's kind of embedded in the announcement, but it's not just Google Cloud.
That's right, and I think in that sense, Anthos is a game changer. It's not just an incremental improvement to something that's existing for customers. It's not like it's just something faster or cheaper or adds more features. It's actually something that allows them to do something they couldn't do before, which is have a consistent platform that they can use to write once and deploy their workloads anywhere, on-prem, in GCP, and that we had, but expanding that to any cloud, not just Google Cloud.
I want to get you guys' thoughts here because you got a brain trust inside Google Cloud, because I've been talking on theCUBE about this and publicly. There seems to be confusion around what multi-cloud means. So a company is an enterprise. There's a lot of things going on in the enterprise. So certainly the enterprise will have multiple workloads. So there's certain situations that some people say, hey, this workload will be great on this cloud. This workload will be great on that cloud. So it's not about having a cloud for cloud's sake. Oh, we got to standardize on Google, we got to standardize on Amazon. Instead, people, what I hear, and I want to get your thoughts and reaction to, is I'd like to have a workload that has data, highly addressable, really low latency for this workload, and a cloud for this workload, but together it's multi-cloud. This seems to be a trend. Do you guys agree with that? Is that something that you're seeing? Is that the main message here? Is that it's not so much standardize on a cloud, but have multiple clouds, pick the right cloud for the job kind of philosophy. What's your thoughts? This is kind of a philosophical question.
So this is exactly actually what we are hearing from our customers about their multi-cloud strategy. And exactly what you're saying, so this is actually for most of them is a reality, right? Either because they've been organically building things in the cloud or they want to get to multiple geographies. And it's not only a cloud vendor, we need to remember that on-prem, this is where most of their workloads are still running and where they still need to innovate. Or when you talk about retail or banks, they have their branches and the stores where they need to have compute at. So really services are spread all over. Now the question is, this kind of situation creates a lot of risk for our customers. Security risk and talent fragmentation, which are related. So how can I manage all of those environments?
The risk is multi-cloud or one cloud? Or
so multi-cloud actually increases the risk even further. So they already have a multi-cloud reality. Okay, that's their strategy forward. But how can they mitigate risk with that reality? And we are talking about Kubernetes gave you portability of workloads, but how can you do portability of skills, right? And making sure that your talent can really focus where it matters and not be spread too thin, right? So this is one example that I think Anthos is really unique about from using it from our hosted control plane on GCP.
So let the workloads decide what's best for the workloads and let the clouds naturally use Kubernetes.
Yeah, so I mean, one thing I've seen in our customer base is, you know, the line of business wants to innovate and they want to use the best service for whatever it is that they're doing. And the different clouds have different types of services. They have different strengths. So you don't want centralized IT to say, hey, no, actually you can't do that. You have to follow this policy. We've seen many examples where centralized IT is taking months to approve cloud services, and they've got a backlog of hundreds of services that they need to approve. That's really slowing down innovation. And why is that happening? Because you don't have a consistent platform that you can run and use across clouds. Yeah. Like you said, Kubernetes actually solves that. Yeah. And so that's why we're introducing Anthos based on Kubernetes, so that you don't have that risk, you don't have that fragmentation, yeah, and you can innovate
faster. And I hold on, Stu, one more question, and I think what compounds the complexity is old procurement rules might slow it down. I got to buy this. So the old baggage on procurement standards, it's kind of a moving train.
Right, right. Yeah, I mean, your enterprise has its policies. I mean, we've been talking to some of the largest banks. We had HSBC on stage with us, you know. We had Loblaw, which is one of the largest grocers. We have Kohl's. These companies have policies, and they have compliance requirements, and these are very valid compliance requirements, and they need to be adhered to. It's just how can you speed that process up? And if you have a platform that actually spans environments, doesn't look different in each environment, you can imagine that that simplifies the process, right? It simplifies the approval process because the platform's already pre-approved. And then new services as they come online, if they follow a certain pattern, right? They're Kubernetes approved services, then it's much easier to approve them. And it's much easier to unlock that productivity without increasing risk.
Okay, if I could poke on that just a little bit, Kubernetes approved services isn't a term I've heard yet. When I look at, you know, there are dozens of providers out there that have Kubernetes.
Yes.
And Anthos I know is different, but if I go out there and use Kubernetes from a different cloud provider or a different service provider, you know, Kubernetes is not a magic layer. Everybody builds lots of stuff on top of that. And a concern is if I just have a platform that spans all of these environments, there's skill set challenges, and do I also get a least common denominator? It's cloud is not a utility. GCP is very
That's
different
right.
from the other clouds. So how do I balance
You're
that,
right.
and how do I make sure that I'm, you know, actually being able to get the most out of why I choose a specific platform or cloud?
Right. So that's where Anthos is that layer that actually is more than Kubernetes. We have in Anthos, an opinionated platform from Google that utilizes Kubernetes, but it isn't just pure Kubernetes as you would experience it, say, from the open source with the fragmentation. We're working with certified Kubernetes distributions, and we've got this marketplace where the applications that are in the marketplace have been tested and certified and are supported by a set of partners as well as by Google Cloud to run on these different distributions that you connect yep. and register with Anthos.
But to give maybe another perspective for that, what we have seen with Kubernetes is that customers do appreciate that consistency. Right? They've been demanding, for example, that all Kubernetes distribution would be conformant. And you know, we had an announcement with VMware on stage today about consistency and how we can integrate PKS into Anthos. Right? So I think what customers are telling us, that they really appreciate, they don't want us to innovate in that layer, right? So they appreciate us using open APIs and using extensibility, which is predefined and actually allows that interoperability of services. And this is something that's really in the foundation of Anthos.
Well, you guys done a great job. We've been following the progress from day one and watching the foundation of Google Enterprise grow. You guys have been big contributors. Congratulations to your work. It's
Thank you. Great
to see the progress, and it seems to be getting, the train's moving faster on the tracks, so congratulations. I guess my final question for you guys is, boil down Anthos to the folks watching that are in IT, they're trying to solve some problems, like again, a lot of people realize and wake up, well, I got multiple clouds. And that's not anecdotal, that's reality. They see billing statements from multiple vendors, they still want maybe hybrid. What does Anthos mean to those people? What is it about? What is it? Like, I mean, I'm trying to get bumper sticker it. What's the bottom line? What is Anthos?
So Anthos gives you choice without the risk. That's the bottom. That means that they can choose an existing service or a new greenfield service to use on-prem or in the cloud, containerized or uncontainerized, and they can build on top of that at their own pace. So that's the choice, and they can mitigate risk by giving those tools to manage that consistently. And the other thing I would say for something that we are not talking a lot about because we are focusing about technology and requirements and constraints is what we hear about our customers, that Anthos is good for the engineering teams. And what we hear our customers say that because they are choosing this technology, their talent is appreciating that they can use the best and latest technology, and their skills are portable to other areas as well, and they can attract the best talent. So that, to me, is a very big value for those that are looking to do digital transformation.
Okay, I'll take a crack at it as well. So Anthos is Google's opinionated solution for hybrid and multi-cloud. And it is, like Hen said, something that mitigates risk and gives users choice so that they're not locked in to a particular cloud, and instead they can build once and deploy anywhere. And from a technical standpoint, it's three things. There's a multi-cluster, multi-cloud management plane that's hosted in Google Cloud. Number two, there's a service management layer which actually bridges your monolithic migrated services with your greenfield services that are containerized and treats them all as services that you can secure, manage, and control. And then number three, we have an awesome marketplace from which you can deploy Google services, you can also deploy partner services, and you can deploy them into anywhere that Anthos is registered and can run.
So Anthos embraces the cloud. All clouds, all services.
It does.
Anthos embraces the user. And it puts the user first.
and
yes.
business benefits, good choice, lock-in options,
yes. yeah,
negotiating contracts.
Let a thousand flowers bloom, right?
Developers love it, ops going to love it. That seems to be
Leaders
the three areas.
Leaders love yes. it.
Guys, congratulations. Thanks for the insight. Love the explanation of Anthos. Thanks for sharing. Appreciate
Thank
it.
Thank you.
Thank you to Aparna Hen. Thanks for coming on. CUBE coverage here live in San Francisco. We're breaking it down. Google Next 19, day one of 3 days of live CUBE coverage. We have all the thought leaders, Google executives, all the engineers coming on to explain to us what's happening. Thanks for watching. Stay with us for more after this short break.